See this, our last chapter under Financial Accounting 5 is Company Final Accounts. So whenever we are discussing about final account, so there are two important things we have to see. That is, first one is profit and loss account statement we have to do, and second thing we have to do is the balance sheet. And whenever if you see the question, usually this type of question comes for 24 mark, and in the question they will give you the trail balance. So trail balance will contain various type of items showing the debit as well as credit side, and after the trail balance there will be some certain adjustments will be given. So that we have to see. So first of all, we have to discuss about the profit and loss account statement. So profit and loss account statement, you know, it is an income and expense statement, or it is also known as income statement. So under that there are nine notes under company's new balance sheet format, that is vertical form of balance sheet, Companies Act of 2013. So that is starts from working note number 22 till working note number 30. So after doing the profit and loss account, the final answer of profit and loss account, whatever you are getting, is nothing but it is a profit for the period. This profit for the period you have to consider under working note number 2 under balance sheet. So totally, while solving this problem, there are total 30 working notes that we have to consider. 30 working notes. Yes. So now we'll discuss what are those working notes, and we'll discuss in brief. See this, every company is required to prepare final accounts at the end of the accounting year. So final account includes statement of profit and loss and the balance sheet of the company. So before, what we used to do, we can prepare the horizontal form of balance sheet. But after 2013 amendment, we have to company have to prepare the vertical format. So under vertical format there are various heads. See this, the format of balance sheet is given. So there are three columns: particular, note number, and amount. So note number you have to write as it is, and you cannot change the note number. You have to write the specified note number for the specified information. For example, share capital means note number 1, reserves and surplus note number 2, like that. So now first we'll discuss about equity and liabilities. Under liability side there are total 10 notes. If you see, total 10 notes are there under that first liability side information, that is equity and liability. So what do you mean by equity and liability? So usually here we are talking about shareholders fund. Shareholders fund means equity share capital, or any capital given to the shareholder, any premium given to the shareholder. So everything comes, and profit and loss account trade balance given to the shareholder. So these all information comes under equity and liability. So under equity and liability, if you see, first point is shareholders fund. So under shareholders fund, working note number 1 is share capital. So what do you mean by share capital? Share capital means it is a total amount of capital available in the company. So it may be called up capital, it may be paid up capital. Paid up capital means the amount paid by the subscriber, that is known as a paid up capital. Called up capital means whatever the amount called up by the company. Similarly, there is an authorized capital, maximum amount of the capital that the company can issue. So these all things are there under share capital. Similarly, if there is any calls in arrears, if some calls are not paid, calls in arrears are there, that also comes, certain adjustments we have to make. So these things comes under share capital, working note number 1. Usually if you see the problem, they will give you either share capital directly, or they may give you equity share capital and preference share capital. So directly you have to show that information under this working note. Next, reserves and surplus, that is note number 2. So reserves and surplus, again here reserves means general reserve you have to write, and all the transfer to the reserve fund. If a transfer is made during the year, or in the previous trail balance, if there is any transfer amount is given, that you have to consider. Suppose a debenture redemption fund, whatever the fund transfer, you have to consider under reserve of working note. Then there is reserves and surplus means, surplus means here profit and loss account.
we have to see whether there is a profit and loss showing the debit balance or credit balance. If it is showing the credit balance, then we know there is a profit to the company. If it is showing the debit balance, then we know there is a loss to the company. So that we have to consider profit and loss account statement. Then we have to see if there is any brought forward profit and loss account information. If there is any brought forward information that is from previous year profit, that may be given in the trail balance. If that is given, that also we have to consider for profit and loss account information. So reserves and surplus account, that is working note number two, usually has two categories. One is all the matters relating to the reserve. Surplus means all the matter relating to the profit and loss account. Then so these two working note comes under shareholders fund, first two working note under liability. Then second heading, if you see, share application and pending money allotment. So what do you mean by share application? You know, company has to issue the share in order to raise money from the public. Whenever the company issues the shares to the public will subscribe the share. So whenever public is subscribing the shares, what happens? Company will get share application amount. But sometimes what happens, share application amount may be more, or the actual amount received by the company is more than what is actually company is going to offer to the public. In that case, company has to make the decision whether we have to give the shares as per the pro rata allotment. That means, suppose if there are five shares are there, sub can we issue two shares instead of five shares? Can we issue two shares for each category of shareholder? So like that, certain decisions company have to take. Until then, this whatever the amount received by the company, that is share application amount, will be there in company's fund. So such fund is treated as a liability. That is why share application is treated as liability until the allotment is made. That is why pending money allotment is given in the format of the balance sheet. For that, there is no working note number. Working note number is not there, only dash. Dash you have to write, and if there is any information regarding the allotment is given in the question, you have to consider and write in this particular heading. Yes, that is about working note. Number is not there, but heading number two. Then third one, non-current liability. Non-current liability means anything which is more than 1 year. Why current means current liability means usually it is for a shorter period of time, usually less than 1 year. Non-current liability means it is more than 1 year. So under non-current liability, if you see, there are various categories are there. First one is a long-term borrowing, working note number three. So what do you mean by long-term borrowing? Suppose company has taken loan for a longer duration. It may be for 5 year, it may be for 10 year, 15 year, 20 year, like that. In that case, there are two categories of loan. One is secured loan and second one is unsecured loan. What do you mean by secured loan? Secured loan means whenever company is taking the loan, company also gives certain security to the creditor, the one who provides the loan to the company. Why? Because in case company makes any default in payment, in that case, creditor can make use of that security to recover the amount that is whatever is not paid by the company. That is the meaning of a secured loan. Both are long-term in nature. Then, what do you mean by unsecured loan? Unsecured loan means there is no security is given by the company. Just the company asks for the loan from one creditor, and the creditor, without asking the security, issues the loan to the company. So here, no guarantee is there for creditor in case of default by the company. That is known as a long-term borrowing, working note number three. Then, deferred tax liability. That is working note number four. What do you mean by deferred? Deferred means something you are postponing for the future period of time. Then liability means something which is due. So deferred tax liability, when it arises at the time of payment of taxes. Why? There are two categories of profit. One is book profit and second one is tax profit. So what do you mean by book profit? Book profit means something which you actually incur for during one accounting period or one operating cycle. Whereas a tax profit is something on which you are going to pay the tax. That means on which the company is going to pay the tax. So usually there may be some difference between the book profit and the tax profit. That is why there is a scope for deferred payment or a postponement of payment. So now we have to see deferred tax liability means what? Whenever book profit is more, tax profit is less. In that case, what happens? A company is going to pay the less tax for this present accounting year. But next year, of course, a company is going to pay some amount because there is a due amount. Now the company is not paying. After this one accounting year, company is going to pay the due amount. So that is why it is known as a deferred tax liability. Book profit more, tax profit less. Then other long-term liability. What do you mean by other long-term liability? Working note number 5. Other long-term liability means something which is specified in nature. If it is specifically given in the question, that is other long-term liability, then only you have to consider. Or else you can't take any common item under other this one long-term liabilities. That is working note number 5. Usually in your question, it will be nil, because no such information will be given. Then long-term provision. What do you mean by long-term provision? So provision means a certain type of fund you are keeping to meet certain purposes. Suppose there is a taxation provision. So what do you mean by taxation provision? To pay the tax, you are keeping certain fund. But usually taxation provision is a short-term provision. Why it is short-term provision? Because every year you have to pay the tax. So during that one accounting year itself, that amount you are keeping aside. So taxation provision, short-term provision. Long-term provision means something which has more than 1 year. If anything is given in the question, then it is known as a long-term provision. Suppose if you are pension fund, if there is given in question, then you can see whether it is a long-term provision or not. That is about working note number 6. Then, fourth heading, current liability. So now, till now we have discussed equity and liability, heading number 1, under that 2 note is there. Then share application and pending money allotment, heading number 2. Then heading number 3 is non-current liability, under that 4 category. That is working note number 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, heading number 4, current liability. Current liability means something which can be converted into cash very quickly, or which has a ability of liquidity. Liquidity is there. Usually short term in nature, current liability. See this, short term borrowing. If there is any short term borrowing, if there is any loan taken by the company for less than 1 year, it comes under working note number 7. And trade payable. What do you mean by trade payable? Trade payable means creditor. Here payable means it is relating to the creditor. So creditor information you have to write under trade payable. Similarly, trade receivable information will be also asked. That is there in the format, trade receivable. Trade receivable means what? It is relating to the information of a debtor. So creditor, you know, the person who gives the money. Debtor, you know, the person who is going to pay the money to the creditor. So trade payable includes the creditor. Then other current liability. What do you mean by other current liability? So for example, bills payable is given in the question. So this bills payable comes under this category, other current liability. Similarly, there is a bills receivable is there. So that you have to show under other current asset. Similarly, there is a preliminary expenses that we will usually show in the asset side. That also comes under other current asset. Then short term provision, like any tax expenses. If any tax expenses are given, like provision for taxation, that you have to show under short term provision, working note number 10. So now all the working note number is very important. Short term borrowing 7, trade payable 8, other current liability 9, short term provision 10. So total of the liability side will be shown in the outer column. After that is the amount column total you have to do. All the amount you have to write in the amount column, all the note amount. Finally, you have to do the total. So this total should be equal. So that means the asset side total should be equal to the liability side total. Then the problem tallies. So now total 10 working note we have seen under liability side. Similarly, there is 11 other working note are there for asset side information. That we have to see now. See this. Now we are discussing about asset side. Asset side means we are doing the balance sheet vertically. So there is no such asset side and liability side. So first you have to show liability and below that you have to show asset, because it is a vertical form of balance sheet and not the horizontal form of balance sheet. So here you see asset side, first one, non-current asset. Non-current asset means something which is not held in the business for the purpose of making sale. It is kept in the business for the purpose of usage. So if you are making the sale, then it cannot become this one, non-current asset. So usually it is a long-term in nature, non-current asset. See this, fixed asset, building, machinery, anything is given, you have to write under fixed asset. And you have to see whether depreciation given in the trail balance or whether depreciation percentage is given in the adjustment. If depreciation percentage is given in the adjustment, then you have to deduct from this fixed asset. If depreciation given in the trail balance separately, then depreciation you have to show separately, because there is P&L account, there is one more separate working note is there. There you have to show. And fixed asset, same amount. Suppose fixed asset 5 lakh is given in the trail balance, depreciation given separately, depreciation on building that is 2000 given separately. So you write 5 lakh under fixed asset, that's it. Depreciation you need not show here, because you will show it under P&L account. That is working note number 11, fixed asset. Now, second one, non-current investment. So investment may be investment in a share, investment in a government bond, investment in a mutual fund. So anything, investment which is a long term in nature, or usually it is more than 1 year, comes under this category. Investment, separate heading, that is current, this is not current investment, non-current investment, long term in nature. That is working note number 12. Then the deferred tax asset. Again, deferred means postponement. Assets, we know, something which is essential to the business and it has a positive balance. In this case, what you have to see, that is book profit and tax profit. Now what happens? Book profit is less. Now book profit is less, tax profit is more. In that case, you are paying the more tax now and less tax later, because you are clearing all the dues in the present accounting year, and next year of course you have to pay only the amount of whatever incurred in that particular year. That is why it becomes a deferred tax asset. Deferred tax asset, usually in your question it is nil, because no adjustment will be given regarding this one, deferred tax one. Yes, next, long term loan and advance. That is working note number 14. So why it is given in the asset side? Can anyone tell me why loan is shown in the asset side? Can you tell me now? Akamsha, Amrita, Angita, Anusha, Ashish, Kushal, Narasimha, Nishant. Yes, Swati, Vivek. Tell me why now loan is shown in the asset side? How loan becomes asset? Can you tell me? Yes, tell me. Loans and advance, asset side, why? So my question is, whether company is taking the loan or whether company is giving the loan. Can you tell me now? Here, loans and advance means whether company is taking the loan or whether company is giving the loan. Amrita is saying loan given by the company to outsider. Yes, correct answer. That is why we have to show this in the asset side, because it is a loan given by the company to other parties. So asset side it comes. Advances, see this. Advances, they are specifically given. By seeing this, you have to know. Your company is giving the money to others. Next, other non-current asset. Again, unless and until it is specified in the problem, this balance is nil. Other non-current asset, working note number 15. That is main heading 1 under asset. Then, second thing comes is current asset. Current asset, shorter duration. Under that current investment, less than 1 year if there is any investment, working note number 16, that is current investment you have to show. Now, inventories. What do you mean by inventories? What do you mean by inventory? Can you tell me now? Inventory means what? What is the other word for inventory? Yes, can anyone tell me? What is the other word for inventory? Inventory means you are keeping some stock, isn't it? So inventory is somewhere is equal to stock. So whenever we are talking about inventory, we have to see opening stock given and closing stock given. So what is our opening stock? Suppose our opening stock is 50,000 and our closing stock is 60,000. Opening 50, closing 60. So in that case, what is our inventory balance? Inventory balance is a negative balance. Why? Opening is more, but stock which is not sold, which is there in the company's balance sheet at the end of the financial year, is more than what was there at the beginning of the financial year. That is why inventory shows a negative balance when the closing stock amount is more than the opening stock amount. Whenever opening stock amount is more than the closing stock amount, in that case, inventory shows a positive balance. So here, inventory working note number 17, you have to consider two information. Stock opening and stock closing. Next, trade receivable. Trade receivable working note number 18. So what do you mean by trade receivable here? Trade receivable means, as I already told, it is about a debtor. Debtor, whatever given in the question. And you have to see whether there is a bad debts. Bad debts, whether it is there, whether it is a new RPT is given in the question, usually percentage will be given in the adjustment. So that way, by using that percentage, you can find out what is the new RPT. Suppose the debtor given in the trail balance is 30,000 and percentage given in the adjustment is 5%. So now you can easily find out what is the new RPT. Then what is the old RPT? Old RBD means whatever the RBD reserve for doubtful debts or reserve for bad debts, whatever given separately in the trail balance. That also we have to consider. So every information we have to see for trade receivable, whatever the information regarding the debtor. Then cash and cash equivalent. Now next thing comes is cash and cash equivalent. So here two items usually comes, cash and cash equivalent means cash in hand. Cash in hand, and next thing is cash at bank. If these two information is given, then you have to consider under working note number 19, that is cash and cash equivalent. Then working note number 20, short term loan and advance. Again, loan or advance given by the company, usually less than 1 year, comes here. Working note number 20. Then other current asset, bills receivable, preliminary expenses, all this information you have to show under other current asset. Finally, you will get the total of all the asset, that is from working note number 11 to working note number 21. So final total will be equal to the total of liability. That is 1 to 10 working note total is equal to 11 to 21 working note total. So this is the format of balance sheet. See this format of balance sheet. That is liability side, there are four headings: equity liability, share application and pending money, non-current liability and current liability. Asset side, if you see, that is non-current asset, current asset, only two headings are there. So you have to remember all the working. First thing you have to do, you have to read the format, because without reading the format, it is very, very difficult to solve the problem. You have to remember working note number and what is the name of that working note. So 21 the working note, whether it is possible to remember. Can you tell me now? Yes, whether it is possible. 21 working note. Can you remember? So if we discuss more and more problem, then it becomes a habit. Then we can at least remember some of the working note. Then if you go through almost 5 to 6 problem, then automatically you can remember this working note. Then now after discussing this format, see this format of balance sheet, 21 working note, briefly we have discussed. Then we have to see profit and loss account. See this now. Profit and loss account working notes we have to discuss. So statement of a profit and loss account for the year ending, particular note number and amount. Three columns you have to do. So now first one, revenue from operation. So what do you mean by revenue from operation? What item comes under revenue from operation? Can you tell me now? Revenue from operation. Operation means what? Operation means what? Can you tell me what do you mean by operation? Operation means activities conducted or activities done by the company in day-to-day proceedings or day-to-day business. So if a company wants cash, then what they have to do? If a company wants cash, or if company wants cash to come in, then what company has to do? Tell me whether company has to purchase or whether company has to make the sale. Can you tell me? Sale or purchase? Yes, answer. Sale or purchase? Tell me. Akamsha, Amrita, Ankita, Anusha, Ashish, Kushal, Narasimha, Nishant, Swati, Vivek. Sale or purchase? Very simple. Company has to make the sale. So company has to make the sale. So when company is giving something to the public, then only company can receive something from the public, isn't it? So revenue from operation is nothing but sale. Sale information you have to consider. So sale information, whether it has a credit balance or debit balance. Can you tell me now? Sale information, credit or debit? Very simple this one. Credit balance. Mm-hmm. So credit balance is there. Then one more thing you have to see, whether there is any return. Sales return is given in the trail balance. So sales return as an opposite balance. If sale has a credit balance, then of course the sales return as a debit balance. So debit balance you have to deduct from the credit balance, then you will get revenue from operation. So sale minus sales return, you will get revenue from operation. Working note number 22, that is the first working note under profit and loss account. Next thing is other income. Other income, working note number 23. So for other income, what you have to do? You have to see the trail balance credit side, whether there is any other income is mentioned or not. Suppose any receipt of dividend, anything like that is given in the credit side, then that you have to consider. Trail balance credit side information, and you have to see whether it is other income or not. That is working note number 23. So once you get these two working note total, that is working note 22 plus 23, you will get total revenue. Total revenue, that is you have to make one total. That is a final total of the revenue. That is positive balance total you want to make. Now, after this, all the expenses, 24 to 30, we have all the expenses. So first thing under expense, cost of material consumed, working note number 24. So material means what here? Can you tell me now? Material, what they are talking about here? Material means. Material means here basically raw material. Whether there is a raw material, work in progress, stock and spares, such information is given in the question. That you have to see. material balance. If it is given, then you have to consider under this one, cost of material consumed or used, that is working note number 24. Then purchase of stock in trade, purchase of stock in trade, working note number 25. This is nothing but purchase information given in the trail balance. Purchase information will be given along with sales information. So sales as a credit balance means purchase as a debit balance. Debit balance plus purchase, you have to see purchase return, that is opposite balance. Credit balance, purchase return, whether it is given in the trail balance, you have to see. So purchases minus purchases return, you will get this answer now. Purchase of stock in trade, working note number 25. Next, changes in inventory. This is very important. Changes in inventory 26. That is nothing but opening stock minus closing stock. So here you will show opening minus closing stock difference. If it is negative, you have to write negative answer here. That is minus, and you have to write amount. If it is positive answer, positive amount you have to write. So now in the balance sheet, we have discussed about inventory. See this, working note number 17. Here also inventory means stock, but here you have to show under working note number 17 in the balance sheet, you have to show closing stock. Very important. Closing stock you have to show in the balance sheet. Difference amount you have to show in the working note of profit and loss account. That is changes in inventory, working note number 26. Next, employee benefit expenses, working note number 27. What do you mean by employee benefit expenses now? Tell me. Employee benefit expenses, what and all comes under this? Salary given to employee. Salary given to employee you have to take. Then any wages given to employee, that you have to consider. So all these things you have to consider under employee benefit expenses, whatever is given to the employee as a part of remuneration. Then finance cost, working note number 28, finance cost. So here finance cost means they are talking about debentures interest, bank charges, interest on loan. So all these items, debenture interest, bank charges, interest on loan. So all these things comes under finance cost information. Next, depreciation and amortization expenses, working note number 29. So here depreciation, you know, various on the base of various assets, so there is a depreciation. Either it may give directly in the trail balance, or you have to compute by using the percentage. If it is given in the trail balance, then you have to write the information as it is. Depreciation on machinery 5000, it is given, same information you have to write, or else you have to calculate and write. And amortization means what? Amortization means if anything which is written off over the period of years, like suppose there is one advertisement expenditure, it is written off every year, it is written off, or a technical know-how, it is written off over 10 years, over the period of 15 years, over the period of 20 years. So for this year, what is the amortization expenses, that we have to consider. Then we have to write depreciation separate and amortization separate. Then we have to make the combined total, and we have to show under working note number 29. Then other expenses. So what and all comes under other expenses, like director's fee, it is another expense. Carriage inward, it is another expense. Then anything, office expenses, other expense. So there are various categories of other expenses, like if you see the problem and adjustment, then you can come to know exactly what is asked in the examination and what type of expenses you have to remember from the point of your examination. So that we'll discuss while solving the problem, other expenses, working note number 30. So from 24 to 30, if you add all these things, you will get total expense. Total expense answer you will get. Total revenue answer 22 to 23, then 24 to 30 total expense. So now we want profit before exceptional item and tax. So how to get this profit before exceptional item and tax? Can you tell me how to get this one? profit before exceptional item and tax. How to get that amount? Simple, you have to deduct expenses from revenue. That is nothing but total revenue minus total expense. Total revenue minus total expense, you will get what? Profit before exceptional item and tax. That is nothing but total revenue answer, whatever you got here, and total expenses answer after 30 working days. Both you have to see and you have to write the difference amount here. Then, after getting the profit before exceptional item and tax, from that you have to deduct exceptional items. So, now what are the exceptional items? Usually, any dividend tax paid by the company, corporate dividend tax, suppose if it is paid by the company, then you have to show that under this one, exceptional item. Then, if there is any provision, see this, next thing comes is the tax expense. Tax expense means provision for taxation, if there is any, that you have to show under tax expense. Then you will get a profit for the period. That is, profit before exceptional item and tax minus exceptional item minus tax expenses, you will get final answer. This is profit for the period. So this final answer of the P&L account, you have to include in the working note number 2 of the balance sheet, reserves and surplus, under profit and loss account column. Under profit and loss account column, you have to include that information. So these are the 30 working notes. We have discussed it in brief. That is 21 working note for balance sheet, 9 working note for profit and loss account, statement of profit and loss account. Yes. So now you can ask if there is anything you want to ask now. Tell me, any doubt regarding this one? Just tell me now. And one more thing, in the question they may give, prepare the balance sheet in the prescribed form. So if like that given in the question, prescribed form means vertical balance sheet, and you have to do both the things. This one, statement of profit and loss account also you have to do, and balance sheet also you have to show. So I hope you got an idea, just brief idea about all these working note, and better understanding can be done while discussing the problem. So now you see here, there are certain rules are given for preparation of balance sheet. See this, general instruction for preparation of balance sheet. So sometimes theory questions they ask for 6 marks. So that is why we have to see the rules once we have to go through this one. See this, an asset shall be classified as a current when it satisfies any one of the following criteria. So you can, when and all you can treat the asset as current asset. For that they have given certain conditions. See this, it is expected to realize in or is intended for sale or consumption in the company for normal company's normal operating cycle. So in short, asset which are kept in the business for the purpose of sale is comes under current asset. Or if you want something liquidity from that, in that case also it becomes current asset. Next, it is held primarily for the purpose of being traded. That is means for either for sale or for dealing or settling of all other transactions, other liabilities. In that case also it becomes a current asset. It is expected to be realized within 12 months after reporting date. So within 1 year if you realize the asset, it becomes current asset. It is cash equivalent unless it is restricted from being exchanged or to settle a liability for at least 12 months after reporting date. So nothing but it is a liquidity is available here. If liquidity is available, that means ability to convert the asset into cash as very quickly. In that case, it becomes current asset. So there are four just a statement they have given. Then all other assets shall be classified as non-current. That means fixed asset. Other than these, all other assets are non-current asset. That is rule number 1, general instruction for preparation of balance sheet. So now, second thing they are saying is about, see this, operating cycle. What do you mean by operating cycle? An operating cycle is a time between acquisition of asset for the processing and their realization in cash or cash equivalent. Whereas a normal operating cycle cannot be identified, it is assumed to have duration of 12 months. So you can say here our accounting period or one financial year, that is from April to March, that you can consider as a normal operating cycle or the duration of 12 months. So that is about this statement. Next, third one, you see, a liability shall be classified as current when it satisfies any one of the following criteria. And all these rules, these criteria are similar to that of a current asset. See this. Now they are talking about current liability. It is expected to be settled in the company's normal operating cycle. It is held primarily for the purpose of being traded. It is due to be settled within 12 months after reporting date. And the company does not have any unconditional right to defer settlement of liability for at least 12 months after reporting date. So if all these things are satisfied, then you can take this as a current liability. And these things are not that relevant, but still I have taken this one in case question is asked for theory question. That is why I have taken this one. Yes. Then all other liability shall be treated as non-current liability. Then fourth one, you see, they have given information about trade receivable. So what do you mean by trade receivable? Usually they are talking about debtor information. So receivable is classified as trade receivable if it is in respect of the amount due on account of goods sold or service rendered in the normal course of business. That means you sold something and amount is yet to receive. You have sold some item and amount is yet to be given. In that case, you can consider this as a trade receivable or a debtor information. Now, trade payable. Trade payable means what? It is related to the purchase or credit. So a payable shall be classified as a trade payable if it is in respect of the amount due on account of goods purchased. And you have made the purchase of something, you purchased some item, or the company has purchased some item and payment is not given. So in that case, what it becomes? Trade payable. It is due from the company to the creditor. So goods purchased or the service received in the normal course of the business or usually within one accounting year. Company shall disclose all the details in the notes to account. That is why very important, while solving the problem, you have to show the notes separately. That means in the format you cannot do the calculation. So that is why 30 notes first you have to do. After that you have to prepare the format. Then you have to fill the total of each working note in that format and you can get the final answer. That is the balance sheet final total you can get. So all this information you have to keep in mind before solving the problem. Yes. So I hope